What's going on, everyone? My name's Eric, and today we have this Alexi Laiho LTD 600 series guitar on deck, but we're not going to be really focusing on the guitar too much. We're going to be focusing on the Floyd Rose bridge. Why we're doing that is because, if you can tell from the title, this is going to be a comprehensive walkthrough of actually how to live and deal with a Floyd Rose. I see so many people online just knocking Floyd Roses and tremolos for that matter, and you know, I personally think that they're great, and especially if you just know how to deal with them, and they don't take a ton of work. They take a bit of learning, but once you figure out how to do that, you know, it's just a little bit of plug-in and play from there on in. And this guitar is also tuned to drop B, but we're gonna actually put it in D standard with some new strings, so I'm also gonna show you how you change tunings and deal with that on a Floyd Rose, because that's another issue that some people have with Floyd Roses, is that changing tunings and string gauges is a pain. So we're gonna dispel those myths, and then you're gonna be maybe thinking differently about Floyd Roses. So without further ado, let's get right into it. All right, so step one here of dealing with a Floyd Rose equipped guitar. So the first thing you wanna do is take the nut clamps off of the Floyd Rose as best as you can and put them somewhere safe. And then you also wanna make sure that the Floyd Rose tremolo bar is actually in the guitar, because then you wanna depress the bar as much as you can and throw something underneath the backs of the screw saddles here of the Floyd Rose, just to kind of trick the Floyd Rose to thinking that it's still under pressure, so that it'll still be level. So you'll have a much easier time taking the strings out and then just kind of restringing it and actually intonating it when you're going to do that. Step two, after you have all that figured out, you want to take all the strings out of the guitar. So you're going to start by detuning the strings at the headstock like you would on any normal guitar. And then you're going to take an Allen wrench and you're going to insert it into the back of the Floyd Rose here on that string lock. And then you're just gonna move it to the left, and then until that starts turning loose, and then you're gonna take the string out of there and make sure the block that is holding the string in doesn't fall out as well, because if that falls out, it's gonna probably go somewhere where it's not supposed to be, and you might have a hard time finding it later. So you wanna avoid that. Turn that string lock screw all the way back in, and that's gonna hold that block in there so you don't lose it. And then you're gonna repeat that 5 more times, or even maybe more times if you have a 6, or if you have a 7 or an 8 string with a Floyd Rose, and then until all the strings are out of the guitar, and then just toss the old strings away. All right, so now at this stage in the game, you know, with any guitar, when you have all the strings off, this is kind of the best time to clean it. So, you know, your fingerboard, your frets, any moving parts you want to lubricate, as I've shown in many other videos as well. And that's kind of it. That's what I'm going to do right now, and then I'll see you back for quick step four. Next up, once the guitar is all cleaned up on the front side and you have all the strings out, what you want to do is then take the back plate off, because you're going to be messing with the springs and the claw a good amount. So the way you want to take out the back plates on a guitar when they're screwed in like this and there's multiple screws, you want to go in a star shape pattern. That's when you're taking them out, and when you're putting them back on, you want to go in a star shape pattern. That is so you don't strip any of the holes that the screws are screwed into, because that is a thing that can happen on a guitar. The next thing you want to do in your Floyd Rose journey is now put the strings on the guitar. So you're going to be feeding them. You can feed them in a few different ways. You can go through the tuner up the top of the guitar, or you can start from back here at the bridge saddle, and then you can throw it into the tuner peg like that. No matter what, you're gonna have to cut the tapered end on the wound strings at some point, so you can't really avoid that. Same with the ball ends of the strings, you're gonna have to cut those at some point, so there's no real right or wrong way to stringing your Floyd Rose guitar. All right, and as you can see, we got the string locked in here. It's all nice and snug. I'm gonna give it just one more turn just to make sure it's all snug in there. And at this point, you just wanna tune the guitar up, and you wanna repeat this just as many times as you have for remaining strings. So I got 5 more times I have to do this, and then you're just gonna get it all tuned up to pitch, and then we're gonna deal with the bridge and then the screws and the claw in the back. Here we go. So now at this point, as you can see, the strings are on the guitar, which is a plus. Now, here's the other thing though. You can see the bridge is level. That's good. But here's the other issue. Guitar is completely out of tune. So now what you're gonna notice when you go to tune the guitar is that the bridge is gonna go either up or it's either gonna go down. So if you're gonna be detuning the guitar to get the guitar to your desired pitch, the bridge is gonna be going down because you are releasing tension off of the strings, and the bridge is then gonna go backwards to that, okay? But now if you need to tune the guitar up, you're gonna realize that the strings, or that the bridge is gonna go up like that, because you're obviously adding tension, you're tuning the guitar up. So this is where the back screws come into play here. The screws and the springs and all that stuff. So essentially, what you wanna do is think of this as like this here, the claw and the screws and all that, that is basically counteracting what the bridge is doing, okay? So let's say the bridge is gonna be down, okay? What you wanna do is then unscrew it, unscrew these, so then that will bring the bridge back up, okay?
But now the bridge is going up
and maybe it's sitting too high or too much of a weird angle. What you have to do is then screw these into the body to then bring the bridge down. So it's either pulling it back in or you're just bringing it back out like that. All right. Now, if you have run out of room and you've screwed all the way into the body, you might need another spring or two, or you can get heavier springs. On a Floyd Rose guitar here, you want the bridge to be sitting flush with the body and use your cavity route here as kind of a guide to keep you flat there. It's not like some of those Ibanez Edge tremolos where they actually sit, their neutral point is at a bit of an angle, which personally I don't like. I like things sitting pretty flat on with the body, you know?
Flat gang, baby! Flat gang.
Essentially, just do that. You're gonna have to do that for a little while. Just keep tuning and detuning. It's annoying, but it is what it is. And I don't know, just put on an album that you gotta listen to. Put on an album of 2022 that you've been dying to listen to, or put on a podcast, pass the time. It's not as bad as you probably think. All right, so now the guitar is like close enough to D standard, but as you can see, the bridge is kind of angled back down. Now at this point, what we're gonna do is flip the guitar on its back, and what you're gonna do to get the guitar's bridge to go back up, we're now going to unscrew. You wanna turn each screw the same amount of times and kind of eyeball to make sure that this claw here, you wanna have to eyeball to make sure the claw here is flat across the body and it is straight, because that'll just make your life a little bit easier when you're going to deal with the bridge and making sure that it's gonna be at a flat neutral point. And then you just gotta keep tuning and messing with the claw at that point until your guitar is fully in tune and the bridge is fully flat. So I'll see you back when that's all done. All right, so now we're back and I kind of timed myself. You know, there was a couple songs that went by maybe 5 minutes at most, and guitar is in tune and the bridge is flat, as you're probably gonna see on screen right now. And honestly, it's just going back and forth a little bit. You have to do small turns, nothing too crazy. And yeah, if you honestly just go slow, make small turns, you're gonna be in really good shape. Now, the next thing that you really want to be cautious of is now setting the action. So let's say the bridge is flat and you like where it's sitting and everything, and it feels good when you rest your palm down when you go to play. Good, but now let's say you wanna take the action down because maybe the strings are just a little too high, or maybe you wanna bring the action up because maybe they're just a little too low. I'm looking down the Floyd Rose, so I'm looking, and I can see the pickup writing upside down. That's how I'm looking at it. I'm gonna go counterclockwise, and that's gonna bring the bridge up if I want the strings higher, and if I go clockwise, it's gonna bring the bridge lower as well, okay? So just depending where you want your action and whatever feels comfy to you, that's how you adjust the action on your Floyd Rose. Now, the other thing you need to be cautious of is that just like adjusting the action on any guitar, the pitch and the tuning will change a little bit, so you will have to retune the guitar. You might have to adjust the claw and the spring on the back depending how far you're going with your action and if the bridge is then moved up or down. So be mindful of that. As I said earlier, just go in small increments and you might not actually have to adjust the claw or the springs in the back at all, which will save you a lot of extra time, especially if it's your first time. As I said earlier, go slow. You don't wanna overwhelm yourself and then, you know, maybe not be inspired to do this again. All right, so pretty well the final step of dealing with the Floyd Rose is the intonation part. So that just means the notes from 12th fret onward are gonna be in tune with the notes that are at the 12th fret and above. So from open to 12 and 12 to 24 or 22 are gonna be all in tune. So now, even though it looks like there's a lot of moving parts here, this isn't too bad, honestly. This is your intonation screw right here, this little guy right here. So what you're gonna do is that you're gonna hit the open string and then you're gonna fret the 12th fret. You're gonna check the intonation like you would on any other guitar. Now, if the note at the 12th fret is sharp, you're gonna be moving this forward towards the bridge. Now if it's flat, you're gonna be moving this saddle backwards. That just involves unscrewing this little screw here and then moving the saddle backwards and forwards. Pretty simple like that, honestly. Nothing too crazy. There's also a few different mounting holes in the actual saddle plate here on the Floyd Rose, the base plate, where you can actually move the intonation screw and the saddle depending on where you actually need to bring the saddle. So again, if you're going too fast, you know, you might be doing more of this than you actually have to. So just go slow and make small movements as you need to. Don't make these crazy big movements because you might just cause more work for yourself. So it's a big thing with the Floyd Rose. Go slow and you're gonna have a good time with it. All right, so the guitar is all done. The action is set, the intonation is set, and the bridge is flat and parallel with the body, which is kind of where you want it for a Floyd Rose. At this point, you're just gonna be bolting back the guitar up. So anything that you took off to get at the strings or the springs, you're then just gonna put them back together. And that's pretty well it at this point. And then you're pretty well set to start playing this thing, you know,
Not too hard, honestly.
All right, and that kind of concludes my short-ish tutorial on how to deal with a Floyd Rose and, you know, to potentially make you think a little bit differently about Floyd Roses, that they're actually not that bad to deal with, you know? I mean, I've been doing these for a while. I've been setting up guitars and with for a while, and Floyds are kind of my specialty at this point. So, you know, maybe I'm a little biased by saying, like, they're not that bad. But honestly, like, if you put some little bit of time and effort, and if you're willing to learn a new skill, you know, they're probably not going to be as bad as you might think they are now. So go ahead, give it a shot, and you know, maybe you're going to think a little bit differently about Floyd Roses. I know I did, especially when I started working on these on my own, or even just regular tremolos, that they're not that bad. You know, as long as you learn the mechanics of them and a little bit of the physics behind them, they're pretty straightforward. You know, obviously they're going to be more complex than a traditional string through bridge or like a hardtail or a tune-o-matic. But, you know, you can do a few more things with these, and if sure, you do have a little bit more complications, like you can't change tunings readily, like on the fly, you know, and there's a lot of different things. Like once you select your tuning, your string gauges, like you're kind of set until you decide to change strings and tuning. You can kind of get lucky by buying the same pack of strings or the same gauges, and then you might not have to intonate the guitar, or you might not have to mess with the tremolo screws and the claw and all that stuff. But otherwise, you know, as I said earlier, like spend a little bit of time with it, throw on like an album that you've been wanting to listen to or a podcast you've been wanting to listen to for a while. Just hang out. I mean, just hang out and take five and chill out with a guitar, right? And honestly, like hopefully you come across this video and check it out, but I mean, there's obviously tons of tutorials on how to deal with a Floyd Rose, you know, and especially because these are my bread and butter, I figured like, well, why not do them? Because basically they're on all my guitars, as I said earlier, besides like the eight strings, the baritones, and like, you know, obviously the basses, because I don't know. Now that has me thinking. I feel like I want to bass with a Floyd Rose because I'm crazy. I don't know. Anyways, if you learned something new in this, or maybe if you think a little bit differently about Floyd Roses after watching this video, let me know in the comments below, because I certainly did when I was probably in your shoes dealing with a Floyd Rose many, many years ago. So yeah, you know, and if you haven't already, consider liking this video and consider subscribing if you like the things that I do, because it lets me know that you like the things that I do, obviously, and it lets me know that I'm doing a good job and that you like what I make for you guys that are watching. And obviously all of your regularly scheduled content, that includes the Pantera stuff, and that includes other gear demos and stuff, will be all down the pipeline very, very soon. I like doing these different little videos, like the setups and all this stuff, you know. I like sharing my knowledge with you guys, and I like, you know, bringing on guitars that I fix up in my own spare time to the channel to share, because they all have their own unique story, and maybe I can even do a cover out of them, as I just did with this one a few videos back. So with all that being said, thanks for watching this video. I hope you learned something new. Let me know in the comments again if you did, and I will see you next time.